Let us see the biological evolution, how the process of biological evolution will start. And here, when you see the geologic time scale and that too the standard geological column, here you can see the different types of eras from and the period and the epochs or and the events that have been taken place during the process of evolution. So if you see here the pre-Phanerozoic era, this is the econ, and the era is the Archaeonic era, and the Protozoic era, this is nothing but the Paleozoic era, and these are the different periods here: Edicarian period, Cambrian period, Ordovician period, Silurian period, Devonian period. What is Devonian period? It is the age or the period of amphibians or the golden age of amphibians. See, and the Carboniferous period, where the reptiles have been formed, and also the Permian periods. Then this is the time scale or at what exact time they have been evolved on the earth. If you look at the events, here in the Protozoic era, you can see the earth's crust and ocean has been formed, and the protocells and the atmosphere has been reduced. How the Hillary and Murray experiments have conducted, and they have shown the different hypothesis with this particular protocells formation. Now the next is the earliest fossils of multicelled marine life. So this theory clearly says that first on the origin or the evolution of life, the organisms which have come into existence are the marine cells or the marine organisms. Later on only the fresh animals have come into existence. So the marine life, sea invertebrates, the different types of trilobites, the sea invertebrates, different types of trilobites, and also the vertebrates, for the very first time they have come into existence during the Cambrian period. And if you see the Ordovician period, that is still only they are in the sea life, that is the marine life was there in the Ordovician period only. The Silurian period, you can see the land plants for the very first time. The land plants have come in this period, and this was around 510 time scale. And only the sea life, only the sea life was also seen at this particular Ordovician period. If you see the Silurian period, the air breathing animals have come into existence, and also the fishes. That means air breathing animals means anabas fishes and the different types of notopterous, all these fishes have come into existence. In the Devonian period, as I told you, the amphibians were the rulers on the earth. Apart from the amphibians, sharks have also been developed, and the insects with the different kinds of wings. Here we can also discuss the different types of evolutions like adaptive radiation, convergent evolution, and the different types of the coal forming forests are also seen in the Carboniferous period, where the reptiles have also been evolved. Here in the, if you see the Mesozoic era is considered to be the era of dinosaurs. They are the era of the dinosaurs. So they have dominated the earth. The dinosaurs have dominated the earth, or in other words, I can say that it is the age of reptiles. Mesozoic era is the age of the reptiles. Here, in the Jurassic period, the birds have come into existence. And the Cretaceous period, we can see the placental mammals and also the flowering plants have come into existence. What are placental mammals? The mammals which have the placenta, and also they have the gestation period during the process of reproduction and also the childbirth. If you see the Cenozoic era, the tertiary period, here so many Paleocene, Ecocene, Oligocene, Pliocene, the first horses have come into existence. The grasses Arthropodians have appeared, the whales, bats, monkeys, early man, and the large carnivores. The quaternary period, here man develops civilization. That means here man started to transform into or change himself into a civilized person.